Hey y'all, Russ, Lead Crayon, coming at you again from ye old front porch. Holy crap, that was some lightning. Whew! Let's see how long it takes the thunder to get here. Let's find out how far away that storm is. Anyway, I just wanted to do a quick video here because... Oh, there it is. That was pretty close. Maybe about a mile and a half, 2 miles. Well, I just wanted to say that I hope that I get to meet each and every one of you who's a YouTube Pipe community member in Nashville. My girlfriend and I are ready, more or less. We'll be leaving out of here about 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. Hoping to get to Nashville around 2 in the afternoon. And enjoy a fine weekend with friends and exploring the town of Nashville. I think it'll be a hell of a fun time, and I really do hope I get to see a lot of familiar and a lot of new faces when we're there. A little housekeeping. If you watched my last video, you've already seen this pipe. It's my Whitehall Balmoral, and I'm still smoking Soli Deo Gloria. So, the other thing, that this video is about, is sort of about this. I wanted to do a quick shout out and thanks to Jeff StogieFarts. He is one of the people that I found really early on when I was exploring YouTube, and I watched all of his how-to videos, as well as how-to videos from lots and lots of other people. But he recently did a sort of recap of all of his information that he put out in his beginner series. Okay, so anyway, my phone decided to take a phone call, which, screw that phone, you're not supposed to take phone calls, what the hell is that about? Anyway, I was saying that StogieFarts did a reintroduction and an encapsulation of all of his early beginner pipe tips. So I watched that, and there was one nugget of information there he put in about the firmness of the pack in your pipe bowl. Now, I've heard 100 people, if I've heard one, describe the amount of pressure you're supposed to put in the bowl. You know, the child's finger, or the child's hand, the woman's hand, then the man's hand. But then everybody warns you about packing your bowl too tightly. So ever since I started smoking a pipe, I have been paranoid about packing my bowl too tightly. So I've been packing them really loosely, and it turns out that that's a freaking problem. Who knew, right? So he said something about the fact that the consistency of the air coming through the pipe should be something like, there should be actual resistance. There should be some resistance to it, kind of like pulling something through a straw, not like a milkshake, but you know, it shouldn't just be free flowing. And the pack needs to be firm enough that there's air going through with some resistance, and then, you know, the ability to get the air through to keep the thing burning with the cake on top, the burnt cake on top, and just kind of moving down through the bowl. And I don't think I'd ever heard it described just quite that way. And the sort of drinking straw reference and the cake, you know, the burnt cake on top, so you can see it there, just struck a chord with me. And all of a sudden, I knew exactly how to pack my bowl. And ever since then, this is like a week ago, every bowl I've had has been perfect. before I couldn't keep them lit. They would burn hot, you know. And the sad thing is I've been doing this for like a year now. So I'm an idiot. But I was so paranoid about packing my bowl too tightly that I wasn't packing it nearly tightly enough. So now I understand. I get it. I grok. Something has formed. Neurons have attached. Things have happened right here in my frontal lobe. And suddenly pipe smoking is 10 times better than it was before. It's just incredible. Interestingly, now I smoke a lot of aromatics. So now that I'm packing the bowl like I'm supposed to, I'm getting all the other problems that I never got before. Like things like gurgle. I never got gurgle before. Wow, another thing of lightning. And that probably actually lit up the screen. But I'm so happy to have those problems now, because the pipe actually stays lit, burns through the bowl, and is 10 times as enjoyable as it used to be. So anyway, thank you, Jeff, for that. I really appreciate you kind of going over it again and finally making it stick in my head how this whole thing is supposed to work. So with that, I hope I see everybody in Nashville. Please drive safely, be careful, or fly safely, or however it is you're getting there. My girlfriend and I are going to be staying at the extended stay in Brentwood. There's a whole group of us there. There's a whole group at the Holiday Inn Express. So we're all going to be in the Brentwood area, and we're all going to be around all the different pipe smoking events and stuff on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So hope to catch you all there. See ya. Ciao. You see? I've been talking and it's still lit. Needs a tamp, but it's still lit. Catch you later. Can you tell I'm finally enjoying this? Lightning's pretty cool too. Little tamp and look at it go! Amazing.